Today we are going to discuss applications of convection. So we have studied what is convection in detail in the last class. So what is convection? Convection is the mode of transfer of heat occurring in liquids and gases. In convection, the actual movement of particles takes place. Whereas in conduction, you have studied no actual movement of particles take place. So convection is the mode of transfer of heat in which heat is transferred by the actual movement of particles. We also studied natural examples of convection, that is land breeze and sea breeze. So now we are going to study what are the applications of convection in our daily life. So there are three applications given in your textbook. One is a room heater, another one is an air conditioner, and the third one is an immersion rod. So we will study in detail one by one. So first one, a room heater. So room heater, as all of you know, room heater is used to heat the air in your rooms. That is, in cold countries or cold climate, if we feel cold, the room heater helps us to increase the temperature of the room. So a room heater is always placed on the floor of the room. So as you see in the figure, this room heater is placed on the floor of the room. So why is this room heater placed on the floor? So the room heater heats up the air surrounding the heater. So here the room heater heats up the air surrounding it. Then what happens to the hot air surrounding the room heater? Hot air is less dense or less heavy. So due to the less heaviness of this hot air, what happens? It rises up. When the hot air rises up, the cold air from the top of the room comes down. So as the cool air comes down, it also gets heated by the room heater, and the room, this process continues, and the room will be filled with hot air. So this is why a room heater is kept on the floor of a room. And room heater works on the principle of this, or the room is heated by the principle of convection. So in your textbook it is given, room heater is always kept on the floor of the room. The hot air from the room heater will be on the bottom, and that hot air rises upwards and the cool air on the top comes down and gets heated. So this is the working of a room heater. So next application that is given in your textbook is that of an air conditioner. So all of you know what is an air conditioner. In short, it is known as AC. So where is this AC placed? AC is placed always on the roof or the top of the room. See, as you see in the figure, AC is placed on the top. So why is this AC placed on the top? What is the use of AC? It is used to decrease the room temperature, isn't it? So what happens? The air surrounding the AC gets cooled. So the cool air, the air surrounding the AC gets cooled, and the cool air being heavy, it comes down. Compared to this cool air, the air at the bottom will be hot. So what happens? The cool air comes down and the hot air rises up. So when the hot air rises up to the premises of the AC, what happens to that hot air? That hot air also becomes cool. And this convection current moves on. That is, cool and hot air coming up and down moves on continuously, and the room temperature will be lower. So this is the working of an AC. Then the third one given in your textbook is that of an immersion rod. What is an immersion rod? As all of you know, immersion rod is used to increase the temperature of water or any other liquid. Usually, we use an immersion rod to heat water taken in a container or a bucket. So, immersion rod contains, or immersion rod has, a coil of wire. When electricity passes through this coil of wire, that immersion, the coil becomes hot. So, what is done there is, we first immerse this immersion rod in the bucket of water, as you see in the figure. So immersion rod is dipped into the water, then the switch is turned on. What happens? The coil here gets heated. As the coil gets heated, the heat is transferred to the water surrounding the coil. So the water surrounding the coil becomes hot. So this hot water, what happens? This hot water near the immersion rod is hot now. So it moves up. And what happens? The cold air from the top moves downwards near the coil. So the cool water moves downwards and that cool water also becomes hot. This process continues. So the hot water moves upwards and the cool water moves downwards. This process continues until the water gets our required temperature. Then we switch off the immersion rod and thus the water becomes hot. So these are the three applications that you have to study of convection. I think all of you have written the notes regarding the application of convection.